The 40 Hadith of Imam Nawawi. Commentary by Sheikh Muhammad Al-Yaqubi.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد رسول الله. Hadith number 7 of the 40 Hadith of Imam An-Nawawi. On the authority of Tamim ibn Aus Ad-Dari, may Allah be pleased with him. He says, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, الدين النصيحة قلنا لمن قال لله ولكتابه ولرسوله ولأئمة المسلمين وعامتهم. أخرجه مسلم. الدين النصيحة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم succinctly and so eloquently in two words defines the deen. What is the deen? Islam. Deen al-Islam. Religion of Islam. What is it? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم says here in one word, النصيحة. It is very difficult to translate this word in one English word. Let me explain to you what it means, and then we'll find a way to put it in English. نصيحة from the Arabic is sheer advice given with sincerity and the utmost level of devotion. It is given with the intention of making things correct. But here, it has something additional. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained that this nasiha is for Allah, for his book, for his messenger, for the political rulers of the Muslim ummah and for the public. So how would you advise Allah? Give a counsel to Allah? This is impossible. This is not what is meant here. This is why nasiha as a sheer counsel given with sincerity does not apply here. Actually, what is meant here is that you give yourself the sheerest and the most sincerest counsel concerning your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in relation to your understanding of the book of Allah and concerning your relation with the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and your relation with the political rulers of your country and your relation with the commons, with the Muslim ummah. That's the advice here. You don't give advice to others, you give advice to yourself. It is sincerity in advising yourself. It is turning to yourself and giving yourself the best counsel in your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the best counsel with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Obeying his commands, loving him subhanahu wa ta'ala, preferring him above everything else. The first aspect of advising yourself concerning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sincerity is believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, worshipping him with sincerity, turning to him always, having reliance on him, having certitude about him, about the rizq he promised to you, etc. What's the best advice you give yourself about the book of Allah is to practice it, to follow it, not to throw it behind your back like other people Allah described to us in the Quran al-Kareem who put the book of Allah behind their backs, is to recite it, to study it, to embrace it, to have your character, the book of Allah as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had it in as much as possible. What's the best advice you give yourself about the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is to follow his sunnah, to love him, to obey him, to revere him, to mention him often, to send prayers upon him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What's the best advice you give yourself about your political rulers is to obey them, not to rebel against them, not to backbite them, not to cause trouble in the society where you live. And what's the best advice you give yourself about Muslims? It is to help them, to be a brother of them, to be part of the community, to show solidarity, to stand for them when they need you, to love for them, as we will see later, what you love for yourself. That's the advice you give here. And see here, nasiha you give to yourself concerning these things the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam defined. Allah bless you. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.